Well, when I was growing up in Swissvale, it was just a comfortable neighborhood. As time moved on, the elders in the family got older, they started to pass away, children started to move away. Things started to happen in the community. There was a few violent episodes, there was a couple of shootings. I heard about the things that were going on in my hometown of Swissvale, and I really felt compelled to come back home to do something to move Swissvale back into the neighborhood that I knew when I was growing up. The community garden idea came when I started the food studies program at Chatham. Every single one of the faculty members, I mean, whether I had them in class or not, they literally were like, how can I help? What can I do? If you need to talk, you know, we'll set up a meeting. I mean, they've just been really helpful in helping me to do the things that I wanted to do in my community.
When I first started teaching at Chatham, I met Leland. He was in one of my classes on urban agriculture. We learned about the benefits of urban agriculture to communities like Swissvale. And so Leland is working to incorporate many of those benefits into the community garden that he's developing there. I think it also really kind of reconnects people to the soil, basically. And people really get a real satisfaction from growing food in their own gardens or in a community garden or an urban farm and sort of seeing the product of their labor. Having these two campuses, both the Eden Hall campus, which is a 388-acre campus about 18 miles north of the city, and having the Shadyside campus, is that the conditions of production are very different in both locations, and so it really kind of exposes our students to a wide variety of social and ecological conditions of agricultural production.
A community garden to me is a communal space where people can, you know, not only grow food, but can have conversations, can share things with each other, create relationships, and just be a community.